Let's try this one again. So we have problem solving skills. All right, so let's look at this. So what are problem solving skills? Problem solving skills refers to the skills and abilities needed to solve problems. It is when we use a thought process to find a solution to a problem. All problems have obstacles that can make it difficult to find a way to fix a problem. The more difficult the problem, the bigger the obstacles. To overcome these obstacles and find a solution, we need to use critical thinking. Critical thinking is when we question and evaluate the information to find a solution or an answer. So we got a first, number one. What are problem-solving skills? Now, the next couple, we got to fill in the blank with the words evaluating, questioning, obstacles, or critical thinking. So all problems have blank. Three, blank needs to be used to overcome obstacles to find solutions to problems. Four, critical thinking is blank and blank the information in order to find a solution. So why are problem solving skills important? The ability to solve problems is an important life skill. Problem solving skill is a skill needed in many areas of our lives. To be successful in our day-to-day lives at school and at work, we need to be problem solvers. Most of us can solve the small problems, but it is the bigger problems that many people struggle with. When you can't solve problems, it holds you back from learning and makes you dependent on others. So true or false, number five. Problem solving is an important life skill. Six, to be successful, we need to be problem solvers. Seven, when you can't solve a problem, it holds you back from learning and makes you dependent on others. So we're on the next page. Why do people fail to solve problems? There are three reasons why people aren't able to solve a problem. First, it may be because they don't recognize that a problem exists. Second, the person may not have the confidence to try and solve the problem. Some people freeze up when they're forced with a problem. To solve problems, it takes confidence and a willingness to fail. Lastly, they now have learned the proper problem-solving skills, which tends to be the most common reason that people fail to solve problems. So number one, some people can't solve a problem because they don't blank that a problem exists. Two, to solve a problem, it takes blank. Three, the most common reason why people aren't able to solve problems is because they don't have the required blank, blank, blank. So good problem solving is all about following a process or steps. People that are in the problem solving business, such as detectives and scientists, understand that the nature of problem solving, they are aware in order to solve a problem, you must follow these steps. There are five key steps that problem solving experts use. They call it the ideal process. These steps are: identify if a problem exists, define the problem, examine ways to solve the problem, act, and look at your results. So four, what is good problem solving all about? Five, how many steps do expert problem solvers use? What do experts call the five steps of problem solving? Seven, what is the ideal process? What is the first step of the ideal process? And eight, what is the final step of the ideal process? So here's the chart for the ideal chart. So the ideal steps to solving a problem. So you have to identify if the problem exists, define the problem, what exactly is going on, examine the problem, and there are four ways you can examine it. You could create a visual or draw a picture. You can guesstimate, a trial error approach. You can look for a pattern, or you could do research or seek advice. Four is act. Try one solution. If it doesn't work, try some more. And five is look at results and learn from your experience. So we're at this one with the questions. What does the ideal chart show? Fill in the blanks. The blank steps to solving a problem. 1. Identify if a blank exists. 2. Blank the problem. 3. Ways to solve the problem. 4. Blank and adjust. 5. Look at your blank. 3. In step 2, when you define the problem, what should you do? 4. For step 4, if one solution doesn't work, what do you need to do? 5. In step 3, look for possible solutions. What are 4 ways to find a solution?